Good morning, my dear students. In our previous videos, we have learned about conjunctions. We have learned the definition of conjunction. Then we have learned about coordinating conjunctions and subordinating conjunctions. Today, we are going to learn about correlative conjunctions. Now, what do you mean by correlative conjunctions? Correlative conjunctions are the conjunctions that go together. Co means to go together and relate means to show the relationship of one element in the sentence with the other. Co means work together and relate one element of sentence with another. So, the conjunctions which work together to show the relationship, to relate one element of a sentence with another, is called as correlative conjunction. So, correlative conjunctions are pairs of words that connect or create a relationship between other words or phrases in the sentence. Okay, so these conjunctions, they create a relationship between other words or phrases in the sentence. So the most commonly used correlative conjunctions are either or, neither nor, not only but also, both and, whether or, as. So these conjunctions, they depend on one another. They depend on each other, and one is neither used alone. So always they come in pairs. Okay. So let us see the examples. You may have either apples or pears. So either or. It shows the relationship, correlates. It relates one element with the other element. Okay, so these are called correlative conjunctions. Next example, he likes neither fish nor chicken. Neither nor. She got highest score in not only math but also reading. Not only but also. Both radio and television are distracting. Both and. Today, whether it rains or it snows, we will complete a 2-mile run. Whether or. Tina is as intelligent as Meena. So these are all correlative conjunctions. They show relationship between one element to other in the sentence. Okay. Now see here, we have used your either or in the first example. So what does it indicate? It gives you an alternative. So you have a choice either of apple or pears. So any one. An alternate is given. So when there is a choice or an alternate, we use either or. Next is neither nor. So there is a contrast. Neither nor shows contrast. Next is not only but also. Indicates addition. Means she got highest score in not only math but also reading. So in addition of highest score in math, she also got highest score in reading. So it shows in addition. It indicates in addition. Next, both and. Both and also indicate addition. Means radio plus TV. Both are distracting. Okay, so it also indicates addition. Next is whether or. Whether or. Today, whether it rains or it snows. So it shows the condition. In any condition, we will complete 2 mile run. Okay, next. As indicates comparison. As indicates comparison means both are equally intelligent. Nobody is more intelligent, nobody is less intelligent. So there is a comparison between the two. So to show the comparison, we use as. Okay, have you understood? To show the alternate choices, we use either or. For contrast, we use neither nor. For showing addition, we use not only but also, both and. For condition, we use whether or. And for comparison, we use as. These are correlative conjunctions. So now there are certain rules when we talk about correlative conjunctions. Now let us see rules for correlative conjunctions. So the first rule is connect two equal items. Correlative conjunctions connect two equal items. For example, if an article follows one conjunction, the article should follow the other. See the example, either the cat or the dog must go outside. Now, which are the conjunctions in this sentence? Either or. So in this sentence, you see that either follows the article the and or also follows, it should also follow the article. If we write either the cat or dog must go outside, it will be wrong. The sentence will be wrong because it does not follow the grammatical pattern. Here, the correlative conjunction either follows the article the, whereas here it doesn't follow. So, it grammatically it is wrong. It doesn't follow the same pattern. Okay. So, if there is an article after one correlative conjunction, its pair should also follow the article. Okay. Now, see the second example. You should either run or swim today. Now, either or. These are your correlative conjunctions. So, either follows run. Run is what? It is a verb. After or also there is a verb. It means the sentence is correct. If I write, you should either run or verb, but after are or you is a pronoun. It doesn't follow the same pattern. Hence, this sentence is wrong. Do you understand? So, it should follow the same pattern. If there is an article after the correlative conjunction, there should be article after the correlative conjunction. It's pair. Okay. If there is a verb after one, then the pair should also have a verb after it. So it should follow the same pattern. It should connect two equal items. Okay. Second rule, subject must agree with the verb. There should be subject-verb agreement. So the second subject of the sentence should agree with the verb. Now already we have learned subject-verb agreement last year, right? If there is a singular subject, it takes singular verb. If there is plural subject, it takes plural verb. If in a sentence there is one singular and one plural subject, so the subject which is nearest to the verb will agree with it. Okay, so let us see the examples. Every night, either the dog or the cat wakes me up. Now here see, the dog, the cat, both are singular subjects. So we have used here singular verb. If instead if I write every night, either the dog or the cat wake me up, then it will be wrong. Both are singular subjects. So if there is a singular subject, it takes singular verb, right? Next example. Today, neither my sister nor my brothers visit. Now you see here, sister and brothers. One is singular subject, the other is plural subject. So if one subject is singular and one subject is plural, the verb will agree to the nearest subject. So the subject which is nearest the verb, it should agree with that subject. So now here, visit, this is the verb. So nearest to the verb, which is the subject? Brothers. Brothers is plural subject. If I say today, neither my sisters nor my brother visit. See here now, here also there are two subjects, sisters and brothers. Sisters is plural, brother is singular. So one singular, one plural. But which is nearer to the verb? Brother. So it is singular. Hence, visit will be wrong. It should be visits. Understood? So the subject which is nearer to the verb should agree with that verb. Okay, here there is exception to the rule. When we use the correlative conjunction both and, always it will take plural verb. It will not agree with the verb which is nearer. Always when we use the correlative conjunction both and, always it will take a plural verb. Keep that in mind. Okay. So let us see some more examples of subject-verb agreement rules. Not only the horse, but also the goats. Smell, smells nasty. Now see here, the subject is the horse, the goats. One is singular subject, other is plural subject. So when one subject is singular and the other is plural, the verb will agree with the nearest subject. So which is the nearest subject? Goats. So the goats smell, or the goats smells. Goats smell. Smell is the correct answer. Okay. Second example. Both my uncles and my aunt sing or sings well. Now here we have used the conjunction both and. So I have told you there is exception to the rule. Here also one is a plural subject, other is singular subject. But here it will not agree with the subject which is nearer to the verb. As we have used the conjunction both and, always we will use plural verb, that is sing. So if it is singular, so if we see the nearer to the verb, the subject nearer to the verb is singular, so it takes singular verbs. Singular verb is sings, aunt sings, right? But we have used the conjunction both and, so it will always use plural verb. Okay. Next example. Neither a teacher nor students use or uses elevator. Now here teacher and students. One is singular, one is plural. So the nearer to the verb is plural subject. So it will take plural verb use. So neither a teacher nor students use elevator. Either the kids or the dog runs through the house. Now see here, the subject is kids and dog. Kids is plural, dog is singular. So the nearer to the verb is dog, which is singular subject. So the verb will also be singular. So either the kids or the dog runs through the house. I hope you must have understood the concept of correlative conjunctions. What are correlative conjunctions and what are the rules while using correlative conjunctions?